PITBULL, Sam Smith, Lana Del Rey, Ellie Goulding, Pet Shop Boys, Celine Dion and loads more have been taken under the MK unique wings of production. This week on Spotlight, I'll be talking to the legendary house music producer MK about his secret of success. Welcome to Spotlight, the show that shines our love on your favorite dance music artists. I'm Tomoji, and today I'm truly honored to have a talk with one of Detroit's house music legends, Marc Kinchen, better known as MK. The American DJ and music producer has a unique sound and long reputation of success. Not just as an artist with his own original tracks, but also due to his productions and remixes for the biggest names in the music industry. PITBULL, Celine Dion, Sam Smith, Lana Del Rey, Ellie Goulding, Pet Shop Boys and loads more have been taken under his unique wings of production. Marc and myself had a one-on-one conversation in Ibiza about the MK secret of success. This is his Spotlight. We're here on the Spotlight with me, Thomas Jean, and with a true house legend. Ladies and gents, this is MK. How are you?
What's up, man? I'm good. How are you?
I'm good. Well, we're in Ibiza, so...
What? Here last night. I'm ready.
How long have you been around?
Trying to get my age? I
mean, no. Just your famous, like your prestigious career.
Since around 92.
92.
Yeah.
That makes it like a lot, basically. But it's good.
Yeah, no, it's cool. Whatever.
Yeah. So in your music style, the thing that I really like is that you somehow manage to take the old school Detroit sound and to mix it up with brand new vibes. Tell us a bit about this unique style.
Well, I didn't do it on purpose. I think it's just from learning to when I first learned to make house music in the 90s. There was certain things that just stuck with me and what worked, because it was actually when house music first started becoming popular in like late 80s, and those certain elements just kind of stuck with me, and I still include them with production I do today. And usually you can take that little bit and build anything else around it, and it tends to work. And you can even take like pop ideas, pop melodies, and imply it to some of the house techniques, and it just automatically works.
And when you say like pop melodies, like what influences do you have on your music besides Detroit? Maybe like updated stuff as well?
I don't really listen to too many. Well, I listen to Drake a lot. I'm lying. Listen to Drake a lot. But who doesn't?
Yeah.
But I mean, I'm also a producer, and I've been producing my whole life. And I have produced pop acts in the past, and I've dealt
Do some name dropping. Come on.
Snoop Dogg, Jay-Z I worked with, it's SWV, a lot of R&B stuff, like in the 90s, Jodeci, well, PITBULL, I did a lot of songs on PITBULL's project, but I just, even that, just dealing with major labels over those years and starting to understand what the labels want for a pop song to have that radio play. And so I've been hearing it through them, you know, for years and years, where I get it, you know, sometimes it's not my favorite to produce, but I do understand what they want and what elements work in a song to get your to catch your ear.
You can keep that, live through that, live through that, live through that, live through that. let's now turn to your future plans, actually to your current plans, because you've just released a new single with the amazing and talented Becky Hill. I must tell you, I'm in love with the song. I just listen to it when I wake up in the morning and sometimes when I go to bed, if I'm going to bed early. So that's an amazing song. It was played here ten minutes ago. Yeah. It was played here. So tell us just a bit about the song. Okay.
Well, the way that happened is I did a remix for Rudimental about 2 years ago on a song called Powerless, and Becky Hill was the vocalist. And for people that know my music, they know I kind of gravitate towards really good vocalists, or that's just what I like to listen to. And as soon as I signed the deal with Sony, I'm like, I need to get in with Becky Hill. That has to happen. I don't care if the whole album is me and Becky. It has to be Becky. So Becky had something she was working on, and then I got it, finished it, and I called my manager. I'm like, song is out of here, it's crazy. But in the meanwhile, Becky was signed to Universal, I think, so I couldn't put the record out. So for a year we were going back and forth, like, please let me put the record out, please let me put it out. And I would play it at festivals sometimes, and I would look at my Twitter after the festival, and I was like, what song was that? I'm like, oh man. And for literally it went on for like a year. The red tape got cut, song finally came out, and now it's out.
And it's amazing.
Thank you.
When I look back to before we were together, there was no pressure, no pain, just pleasure. We were young, you took my breath and filled your lungs up. I held my tongue and swept up all your poison. You get high, act light, I need rescue. You're walking on thin ice, you don't realize I'm alright tonight.
Tell us just a bit about the new album that is gonna release soon.
The new album, I have a song from Animal England. She's in a group with me called Pleasure State. She also sung Reverse Skydiving with Jamie Jones and Lee Foss on Hot Nature. And I did a song called My Head is a Jungle with a girl named Emma Louise. Emma Louise wrote a song for my album, and Annabelle England is the vocalist. So that ties the whole story together. So there's that song. And it's just a bunch of good songs. It's very dancey. It's a good house album.
Well, we all expect that. Really expect that.
Yeah. And the release date is... I literally turned in the album a couple of days ago. So I'm like, all right, when's the release date? Because I'm trying to find out. You know. And so basically what the label wants to do is release almost all the singles first. Like after Peace Me, there's another one, and then the album. So it's still gonna be a wait.
We're all waiting for that. We are tuned in to Spotlight, and next to me is sitting the legendary MK. You've been around for a long time, so I'm sure that there are loads of new talents that are watching the show now, and they would like to get a tip from someone like you, because you've been producing for other artists, you've been a DJ, a producer, and so something, like, give something to the viewers wants to go the new way.
As far as, I'll give a DJ tip first. As far as DJing, I think the best thing you can do is to not try to sound like someone else. Because right now, there's a lot of DJs that sound like sound similar. You want to be that DJ where you can walk in a club and not see who's playing and say, oh, that's so-and-so playing. That's what you want to be. You'll skyrocket past everyone else. Producing wise, if you're a producer making music in your bedroom, don't really worry about what people think. Don't try to make a song for your friend who's coming over in 10 minutes to say, look what I made. Don't do that. Make a song that you generally, you really feel good about, that you know that you like yourself. Because I think that's what happened with me early on when I was making music. I'm like, I made a song called Burning. I'm like, I really like this record. People around me hated it. Yeah, literally. I can name names, but I'm not going to do it. Because I was in Detroit and I was trying to give it to these labels. And they're like, I'm like, I like it. So I put it out. And it ended up doing really well. I actually got signed. I got a record deal from it. But if I would have listened to, like, the guy walking in the room, I would have erased it. You know? So don't go by, like, trying to impress your friends making music.
So listen to yourself. Follow your heart.
You have to. You have to. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. So now a little bird has whispered to me that you have an obsession for gadgets.
Oh, yeah.
Hello, tell us a bit about your obsession.
It's not a particular gadget. It's anything new that's really cool. For example, when the drones came out a couple years ago,
yeah.
I bought it before I even really knew what it was. I'm like, that looks cool, I'm buying it. Now they have the virtual reality, all the goggles coming out. I already ordered mine. Hopefully it's home by the time I get home. I have no idea how it's gonna work. You know, anytime a video game comes out, I've been that guy that's in line of the store at 7 a.m. waiting for the Xbox to go on sale. I've definitely done that. So that's me. I haven't camped out though, but you know.
One last thing I would like to ask you, because you have been around and doing loads of stuff connected to music, but I'm sure you have something that you still haven't done and you want to do. If it's a collaboration with someone, but also if it's not connected to music, something that MK must do and is really wants to. So what pops into your head now?
It has to do with music though, but I do want to score a movie, score a film.
Wow.
But not in the way that's always, not the typical scoring way. I want to do really abstract scoring of a film.
With your style of music?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's just electronic, that's like, because my thing, even doing music earlier, I would always try to add something in music where that catches your ear. And this is kind of where I got the dubs from, where I would chop vocals and where you have words that you don't know what it's saying. It's more so, it's a melody that sounds good, but also you're like, wait a minute, that's not even the language. But it just catches your ear. So I want to do something like that in film, where the music kind of goes with whatever you're watching, but it's like, it's just something different, yeah.
Yeah, it's great. It's like, yeah, it's a good idea. Kind of creative, to be honest.
Yeah, just be creative. Not necessarily like a big budget film or anything like that, just something that's different. It's never been done before, kind of thing.
Thinking out of the box, right?
Yeah, thinking out of the box.
So if people want to connect with you, want to listen to your music, what's the best like things to do, where to connect to socially?
Spotify right now is the best, because I can put my music on it, and also I can put a lot of music that I play on my sets. Mm-hmm. So say someone see me play for the first time, like I like what he played, they can go to my Spotify and see my playlist. Yeah.
Also, I saw that on your SoundCloud there was a set that I really liked from Ultra Music Festival.
Yeah, 2 years ago?
Yeah.
Yeah. Loves that one.
It's amazing. It's huge. You should check it out. Okay, MK, it was a pleasure to have you on the show.
Sure.
And thank you, and good luck with us. Yeah.
Bye, buddy.
Cheers. Bye-bye.